hanno letto chiamare su un po' di sponsor della faccio questa storia that might be a different style of life. Now, why is that good? We are too hands and too late. The important thing is how can we use it to the maximum in terms of path, straight line, curved line, round line, they might be slow. But depending on the circumstances, sometimes that might not be slow. And in terms of late, you can kick up straight, same thing, right? Now, and after all of that, then you ask yourself, how can you honestly express yourself at that moment? And being yourself that you punch, you really want to punch. Not want to punch because trying to avoid not getting hit, but to really be into it and express yourself. Now that is how that is to me the most important thing. How can I, the process of learning how to use my body to understand myself? Now the unfortunate thing is,
you see, the little arm and shoulder are kind of tends to, you know, definitely for tends to, the radar is, you know, checked in differently, the feet of environment are differently, it's when shoulders too tight. Notice that in the beginning, when I say that you just involve only arm and shoulder, now, your hand, the last time when I saw you was very, very good and fast. Now let's see if this can. You gotta involve your feet a little bit more. Now watch, I think that when I attack you, you know, the reaction of attacking the thing that tightening your shoulder or something. Watch when I try to attack you. I think when you're reacting, you know, then you just do not tense yourself too much, you know? You just then react, you just boom, boom, boom. And that, like I say, you just need that hand just like you said. Okay? You see, when you move your hand and feet, all it makes a world of difference. You see? Watch this one. Put your back if you need to.
A karate punch is like an iron bar. Whack. A bukkake punch is like an iron chain with an iron ball attached to the end, and it goes whack, and it hurts instantly.
Now you will notice a difference in the beginning. You tend to overchange yourself. In other words, you cover too much distance. Therefore, when you kick, then your center of gravity really falls too much, and you perform and kick a great impact. Now, the reason you're going back because your body too much back, and that's what is called a commitment. I mean, when you try to go through something, you're trying to really take the wheel, then you will be able to do it. But you won't do it when you come by looking at you. Now, you see, you are rushing yourself. I mean, you should know it in the beginning. You know, just take your time and go bump and bump. And, you know, see, you still. It's not so much on the physical, mentally, you are changing yourself up, you know? Watch this move in slow motion. Bump, man, bump. But you see, the body line is always there. Instead of overreaching, you know what I mean? You kind of rest back. But as you progress, and don't just think of feeling, that's even better. There's a snap at the end of this one too. The other one you'll just see doing the thing. Boom, 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 boom. All you have to do is just really snap the leg And you just step inside again. That's right. Good. Uh-huh. Now you're not overtrading yourself. Now you're painting yourself more. One and two and three. Good. Now, first of all, I noticed that in this case, that as it progresses, your feeling is more involved in the technique, and consequently, your technique also improves. Now, the foot at the end of the position is usually kind of bending, really, watching. Right? I mean, it's not a definite, substantial, straight line directed at it, and, you know, hit it square and then come. Good. That was a pretty good reaction. Good. You're breathing.
Jikundo is not a style.